Hi, I'm Ben Brownlee for Boris Effect, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to take a Sapphire Vortex effect and add more life to still images, changing it into something much more dramatic. So in After Effects, I have the still image that I am going to be animating up, and we've got it in a 10-second comp. All right, so let's add our first effect, and I'm going to come down to Sapphire Distort and go to Vortex. And we just look at this. It seems pretty extreme. It's kind of, yeah, doing a little vortex in the middle and sucking everything down into the little plug there. There's a lot of stuff we can do with vortexes. I think I've talked about them in previous tutorials as well, but we're going to be doing something a little bit more subtle. So I'm going to set my vortex start to zero, and I want this auto-animating. And the way we do this is with the speed. So if I put my speed to one, you can see it's going to start twisting this up as we move through. And we can end up with something that's, a little bit too extreme, really. And there's a couple of ways of handling this. Either we can change the vortex speed back down, or we can change the vortex start. And this is a little trick that I do quite a bit. If I take my vortex start and send that into a negative place, so it's 10 seconds long, half of 10 is 5, so I go negative 5, we sort of split the difference between the in and the out point. Let's just RAM preview that through and see what we get. And let's look at this now. We've started to get a little bit of motion happening within the image. Now, I like what's going on the sort of borders here, but I do think that, you know, the center point is getting a little bit too vortexy. Here's what we can do. We're going to use a feature now that is available in pretty much every single Sapphire effect, and that's Edit Mocha. If we click on the Edit Mocha button, we get launched into Sapphire Mocha. And take a little look as we play back here. We're just getting our original image. So I'm going to create a series of shapes to mask off the area that we want to see. If your workspace doesn't look like mine, just make sure you're in Essentials mode and it will snap back and look like this. I'm going to use the magnetic layer tool, and I'm just going to click, and that's going to just let me drag quickly around the first cloud that I want to mask out. We can decide how, you know, detailed or not we want to be with this. I'm not going to be amazingly detailed with it because we're just wanting to get like soft shapes and areas around. Let's hold down the X to pan around. And as we go off screen, I'm just going to hold down the Alt or Option key and just do a freeform draw there and right click to close my shape up. Right click again on the handles just to smooth all of that out. And we've got ourselves a little mask there. If I double click on the layer name in the layer properties, I get a chance to rename it, and I will call this one Clouds Front Left. There we go. So I'm going to save that and exit out of Mocha. Now, if I play this back, the vortex is only happening within inside that shape. It's looking a little bit weird. We've got a nice big hard edge. We can soften that edge up a little bit by going into the Mocha category and just blurring that up. I'm going to give that quite a big blur because we're going to just want sort of big soft shapes here. And now we've got this one little area just moving and stretching away. Okay, so that's done it for the front cloud. Let's start working on some of the other clouds as well. I'm going to duplicate my warp vortex. So edit, duplicate, or control, or command D. And I'm just going to come into edit Mocha again and start drawing up the next cloud area. And again, I'll use the magnetic tool and just come in here and maybe grab this area around here. Not going to be too exact because, of course, we are going to be adding a lot of softness to this. Let's just come down and right click again. Right click one more time just to smooth out the edges. There we go. Let's give this a name. I will call this one Clouds Mid Left. And let's take a look at how these are interacting. So if I go to Matte's make sure we're on all mats, and then view mats, mats. If we just save this out now, this second vortex is going to be using both of these areas. And we don't really want that. We want to cut out the first area that we've already got, which is that cloud's front layer. And we can do that very easily. We have the layer selected, go to the layer properties. I change my blend mode to subtract, and then make sure that the cloud's mid left is at the bottom, because Mocha renders from bottom to top. And there we have our shape being cut out. So let's save this again, exit. Now we've got both areas being affected in the same way, because both our vortexes are the same here. So let's change this up. Let's change my vortex speed. Instead of 1, let's take that to 0.6. And instead of the start being 5, we'll set that to 3. And we can even change things like the center point as well, so it makes sure that not everything is rotating around the center or warping into the center. So by changing these sort of small things here, we're going to start to build up a little bit of perspective, because not everything's going to be animating in the same way. And I'm just going to carry on and do a few more of those, just breaking up things in the same sort of way, changing up things like the speed, the vortex start, and the center XY. And a few minutes later, here's what we've got. So let's just RAM preview this. And we've got some subtle movement going, and that sense of 3D happening, because we've, you know, built up parallax using different layers of the warp vortex with the Mocha masks. And actually, while I think about it, let's just go into that last vortex Mocha mask and let's see what I've got here. So I've got my clouds mid, and I'm cutting out using the front and left. I've also got ones for the mid center and the front right, but I've got those turned off. So if these aren't affecting anything that we're actually interested in, it's best just to turn them off so we don't have to render out multiple shapes. It doesn't make that big of a difference, but because we're stacking up quite a lot of warp vortexes over the top of each other, anything we can do to, you know, trim that render time down a little bit is going to be welcome. Now I want to do one last thing, and I'm going to add another warp vortex over the top here. Because using Mocha masks isn't the only way that we can mask stuff out. We can also create mats from layers, and if we're using After Effects, mats from paths. So let's see how that's going to work in practice. I've got another version of my clouds layer here, which is just a black and white grayscale, which is handling the depths. This is really easy to do, but I actually just painted this up in Photoshop. So let's bring this into the comp, and let's come back into that final warp vortex. And I'm going to call this one warp vortex depth, just so we know what's happening here. And with my map from layer, let's check my depth. I'm going to turn off all the other vortexes, so we're only focused on this depth one here. And because we've got the speed set to 0, it's not going to do any animation. But if we play this back now, we're getting quite an interesting little effect, because it's using the luma channel from that depth to show how much it's going to be blending those areas together. If I go really extreme, you can see the edges in a quite extreme way. So let's set this down to 0 again. And I'm going to put my vortex speed in a small negative direction. I think we'll do like minus 0.5 or something. Nothing too big. And so if we play that back, we kind of automatically get a little bit of change happening within our image. So this is almost like free animation. It's really nice. And the one last thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to keyframe in my Z distance. So set a keyframe in at the start, go to the end, and I'm going to move this down so we move forward through the image. I don't want to take this too far, but I will take it fairly far. We'll just sort of eyeball this in and preview. So if we just wanted a little fly through, you know, this is quite a nice way to do it. We get a fly through and we get a little bit of animation in there. But if I add in all of those other vortexes now, and we do another final RAM preview, So you can see here how we can quickly build depth and movement using just Warp Vortex and various masks. And we can, you know, take this even further by adding additional elements, or even just by animating the center XY in the final Warp Vortex that we based off the depth map. And that's where we're going to leave it. I hope you can see the three things I wanted to show you in this short tutorial. One, how flexible Sapphire Warp Vortex is to come in and start adding movement to a still image. Two, how we can start to use Mocha directly within our effect to limit the area that we're affecting. And three, how we can use other source footage to easily create mats that can have a really dynamic effect on our footage. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and join me for more Sapphire tutorials again. If you've enjoyed this video and you want to see more like it, remember to subscribe to the Boris Effects YouTube channel, where you'll be the first to get updates when our new videos are launched. For hours of more free training for Sapphire and the other Boris Effects products, head straight over to borisfx.com.